Father. O Lord, open thou our lips.
And thou shalt
O God, make speed to save us. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Ghost. Praise ye the Lord.
Ecclesiasticus, also known as the Wisdom of Solomon of Sirach. Then Elijah arose, a prophet like fire, and his word burned like a torch. He brought a famine upon them, and by his zeal he made them few in number. By the word of the Lord he shut up the heavens, and also three times brought down fire. How glorious you were, Elijah, in your wondrous deeds. Whose glory is equal to yours? You raised a corpse from death and from Hades by the word of the Most High. You sent kings down to destruction and famous men from their sick beds. You heard rebuke at Sinai and judgments of vengeance in Horeb. You anointed kings to inflict retribution and prophets to succeed you. You were taken up by a whirlwind of fire in a chariot with horses of fire. At the appointed time, it is written, you are destined to calm the wrath of God before it breaks into fury, to turn the hearts of parents to their children, and to restore the tribes of Jacob. Happy are those who saw you and were adorned with your love. We also shall surely live. Here ends the reading.
Thank you.
Gospel of John. Jesus said, "Very truly I tell you, unless a grain of wheat falls into the earth and dies, it remains just a single grain. But if it dies, it bears much fruit. For those who love their lives shall lose it, and those who hate their life in this world will keep it in eternal life. Whoever serves me must follow me, and where I am, there will my servant be also. Whoever serves me, the Father will honor. Now my soul is troubled, and what should I say? Father, save me from this hour? No, it is for this reason that I have come to this hour. Father, glorify your name." Then a voice came from heaven. "I have glorified it, and I will glorify it again." The crowd standing there heard it and said that it was thunder. Others said, "An angel has spoken to him." Jesus answered, "This voice has come for your sake, not for mine. Now is the judgment of the world. Now the ruler of this world will be driven out. And I, when I am lifted up from the earth, will draw all people to myself." Here ends the reading.
Thank you.
I believe in God, endue thy ministers with righteousness. O Lord, save thy people. Give peace in our time, O Lord. Make speed to save us. O God, who before the passion of thy only begotten Son didst reveal his glory upon the holy mount, grant unto us that we, beholding by faith the light of his countenance, may be strengthened to bear our cross and be changed into his likeness from glory to glory. Through the same Jesus Christ our Lord, who liveth and reigneth with thee and the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. O God, from whom all holy desires, all good counsels and just works do proceed, give unto thy servants that peace which the world cannot give, that our hearts may be set to obey thy commandments, and also that by thee, we being defended from the fear of all enemies, may pass our time in rest and quietness through the merits of Jesus Christ, our Savior.
Amen.
Keep watch, dear Lord, with those who work or watch or weep this night, and give thine angels charge over those who sleep. Tend the sick, Lord Christ, give rest to the weary, bless the dying, soothe the suffering, pity the afflicted, shield the joyous, and all for thy love's sake.
Given the state of this planet, this world, with starvation, civil wars, potential nuclear conflict, I bid your prayers for the human family. O God, you made us in your own image and redeemed us through Jesus your Son. Look with compassion on the whole human family. Take away the arrogance and hatred which infect our hearts, Break down the walls that separate us, unite us in bonds of love, and work through our struggle and confusion to accomplish your purposes on earth, that in your good time, all nations and races may serve you in harmony around your heavenly throne. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Amen.
Lord, support us all the day long, until the shadows lengthen and the evening comes, and the busy world is hushed, and the fever of life is over, and our work is done. Then, in your mercy, grant us a safe lodging and a holy rest and peace at the last.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Ghost, be with us all evermore.
Amen.